how to treat low potassium. An important electrolyte that our body needs is potassium. Specifically, it allows our cells to function well since the majority of the potassium content in our body is concentrated inside the cells. One of its most important functions is maintenance of the cell's electrical potential. Any small changes in the potassium level found inside the cells can have serious effects on other parts of the body, like the heart, muscles, and nerves. Other important functions of potassium in the body include muscle contraction, proper regulation of blood pressure by the heart muscle, and control of potassium balance by the kidneys. The normal potassium level in the body is between 3.5 to 5.0 milliequivalents per liter of blood. When a person suffers from low potassium levels or hypokalemia, his or her potassium level is below 3.5 milliequivalents per liter of blood. When this happens, you feel weak due to damaged cell processes. You may also experience any of the following symptoms: sweating, nausea, vomiting, muscle cramping, fainting, constipation, and heart palpitations. If you undergo any of these symptoms, consult your doctor for the most appropriate treatment as soon as possible. How to treat low potassium entails close observation of the symptoms manifested and immediate treatment. Here are some ways to battle potassium loss. 1. Increase intake of potassium-rich foods. Less severe cases of hypokalemia can be treated with a sufficient amount of potassium-rich foods, such as bananas, papayas, avocados, raisins, oranges, pears, baked potatoes, milk, tuna, and salmon. Do not overboil foods, since this will remove potassium. 2. Choose fresh foods. Go for fresh fruits, as they have more potassium content than canned fruits. Don't rely on processed foods for potassium content. In grains, for example, potassium is found in the germ and bran. Thus, the more processed the food is, the less potassium it contains. 3. Drink plenty of water. Since our kidneys do a lot of hard work in regulating the volume and composition of the extracellular fluids in our bodies, drinking plenty of water will help keep them in good condition. This will also keep potassium and other electrolytes in balance. Drinking at least 8 to 10 glasses a day will prevent the onset of water loss, which is one of the symptoms of hypokalemia. 4. Give yourself that needed rest. Weakness is one of the symptoms of hypokalemia, so to ensure that your body increases its potassium level, take enough time to rest. You may even need extra hours of sleep to recover. 5. Ease on rigorous activities. You might have stretched your limit with your workouts, errands, and other strenuous activities. If you are experiencing low levels of potassium, you've got to take some time off until your levels return to normal. Low potassium levels can cause excessive sweating, so sports and other physical activities may make matters worse. 6. Stop taking diuretics. Don't add to your misery by taking in laxatives and diuretics that cause you to urinate more frequently. These could contribute to your lower potassium levels. Consult with your physician as to the diuretics you're taking. Chances are your doctor will tell you to stop taking them or to switch to a less potassium-depleting diuretic. 7. Take potassium supplements. If needed, your physician may recommend potassium supplementation, which is common in treating hypokalemia. For moderately low potassium levels, capsules or liquid potassium may be prescribed. However, for extremely low potassium levels, intravenous potassium may be given. Also, discuss any form of vitamin supplements, as this may affect your electrolyte balance. How to treat low potassium will be of utmost priority for people experiencing hypokalemia, since low potassium would mean an imbalance of electrolytes in the body and malfunctioning of the heart, muscles, and nervous system.